On a night where how they started did not portend a fantastic finish, Rangers win 2-for-2 now on the West Coast and Canada road trip, and they score 3 unanswered in a 3-1 win over the Calgary Flames. Hi, everyone. Thanks for hanging with us inside the Delta MSG studios alongside Steve Valiquette. Yeah. I'm John Giannone. Maybe overlooked in the grand scheme of things here is that second shot on goal against Igor Shesterkin, just 75 seconds in. The Flames had the lead. That is all Shesterkin would allow on this.
He did a really good job of canceling that out. And this game, John, it really reminded me of his performance 2 years ago in Toronto, where he really started to make a name for himself around the league. Calgary will remember this game. That was a performance. That was a stolen win in a lot of ways for Igor Shesterkin. And it was really dynamic in the many ways that he did it. I thought his positioning was amazing, his tracking was on point, and he didn't have to move too much until he was required to do so, and he was able to go to full extension. And I think that he wasn't putting himself out of position early in any of these first plays, which is why he was always available to be able to go into a full stretch and make the acrobatic save. And oftentimes it's all of the work a goalie does before the shot that can either make it hard or easy. And to me, he was always ready, available, responsible to be able to just expand and cover. And that's a game where I'm telling you, people in Calgary that love hockey deeply, you know, they'll remember that night where Igor Shesterkin went in there and he was a brick wall.
You had no doubt, given what happened 5 nights ago when he was pulled from the game in the second period against the Nashville Predators, that he would have a response. Maybe this is why. Now in the regular season, after 5 times being removed from the game for performance, Igor Shesterkin has responded by winning all 5 of the next games with only 10 goals against and a save percentage of .928. What does that most tell you, Steve, about Igor Shesterkin beyond what he does in the net, maybe more between the ears?
Yeah, he's got the heart of a lion, but he's got the mind of a monk, you know, and you need to be able to balance yourself and quiet yourself, trust in the way that you're able to overcome a goal against. For him early on to be able to overcome a goal that's only 1.5 minutes in, to be able to say, look, I'm just coming off a game that I was pulled, and to go through his mental process just to get over it and get back to him playing his game. And, you know, I can't emphasize this enough. He knows where his level is. And I'd imagine when you're that good, that when you're not hitting that level, it can be frustrating, but it always seems to unfold or find itself for him. And, you know, he's never going to be in a funk for too long.
Yeah.
Because he's just too strong between the ears. Mm-hmm. That says a lot about that with the record that you just showed on that graphic. I mean, here's a guy where he's unflappable mentally.
Yeah. Rangers had not won in their last 4 trips to Calgary, had been outscored 18-6 in those 4 games. And after the first 20 minutes, maybe you thought things might go the same way, down 1-0. But then they scored 3 in the second, 2 on the power play in less than 7 minutes, which gave the Rangers the lead. Both power play goals scored in almost identical fashion. We're going to take a look inside the film room powered by CDW and see how both Lafreniere and Kreider were able to score.
That's what they really needed, right? Because the forecheck really wasn't there. It wasn't as robust as it was in Seattle on Saturday, and you're looking for penalty calls. And for the Rangers to start off the power play with number 1 unit and then have the second unit be able to come out and make plays, it really helps where they're able to recover pucks, because it's always about your effort on the power play to get off the yellow. You can see the puck there, it's on the boards, and now when you're face up, you can start making plays out of your setup. Gustafsson, he's been great at being able to slide the blue line. Lafreniere trusts that it's going to be delivered in a way that it's not going to be a headhunting shot, but it's one that he can deflect. Not to go unnoticed here is Cooley is also an option in the high slot. So there's 2 tipping options on that play. Goal number 2 on the power play is Kreider. Same idea. You see the puck on the yellow here. It's their job to get it off the yellow, and now you're in your setup. And this is hard, because as soon as the Rangers get in the setup, I feel like they're at a stage in the season where they're going to get a scoring chance. Same idea for Fox, being able to slide up top, and there was a lot of room from the Calgary box. This allows Kreider to have the lane with the outside stick. He scored 5 goals off that power play deflection 2 years ago. It was really a look that was taken away last year, and this is something that I thought would reappear, because now you can go back to it. Last year, if you remember, it was a lot of Kreider down low blind to Zibanejad, and now it seems like that's being taken away. Mm-hmm. Mika doesn't have any goals yet on the year, but now you go back to it, and that's the benefit of having the experience these guys have down low. And then when they get played tightly like that, you've got Panarin and Fox up top, and they can spin off the cycle. So, again, it's back to pick your poison season. And the best news for the Rangers here, John, you're forcing your opponent to scout two power plays now. And this is something that we haven't seen in recent years. The Lafreniere goal, I mean, they're out there with 50 seconds left in the power play. They're not just getting the garbage 15 seconds remaining. They're getting significant time. So I think it makes it more difficult for any coaching staff. Edmonton's up next. They've got to look at two units. It's just more work for them to do, and there's only so many hours right in the day.
And that was against a Calgary power play that had killed off 21 out of 22 before tonight. But the Rangers scored twice. Gustafsson then scored later in the second period, had that 3-1 lead, and that is how that would end, as they held that two-goal lead throughout the rest of the game.